Well, hello again, this is Hero. What we're doing on this chapter is this crape myrtle. Actually, there's three crape myrtles on this chapter. They were all dug out last year. That was kind of in the way of, my changes. And most of these were from roots that was left when I change the nursery a little bit. What happens is in a can, it comes out the drain hole. And then as I pull the main tree out, the root stays. So it's basically root cuttings. And over the years, it kind of grew. So I took it out and put it in the container. Okay, let's go with number one. I'm going to check the root flare. And see these? These are sort of the volunteers that happen. I think there was a damage to part of the root, and then they reshoot again. So I'm gonna go in here, go back, see it's part of the root system, and go back and cut it off. So, this is our freebie. Okay, now this will not support this, so I'm gonna cut it like that, and it should have a pretty good chance of success. This one is off the trunk. So this will be for fattening this area, so I'm just gonna do something like that, and same with this. This is still on the trunk, so I'm gonna expose more of this. Yeah, a lot of times the first planting we have to do it a little deep so it's stable. But then the second go around, which this will be, we start to expose as much of the surface root as possible. Okay, so see how there's a big root that's coming out? So this will go back into a training pot again, but it will be planted higher. Okay, I think this is the front. It goes up this way, and I'm not sure exactly where the apex is going to be. Maybe about here. I guess that looks okay. And then don't have to spend a lot of time thinking on this because it's still all material. Something like that, right? So you look. So it's going to go back into the container looking like that. So it'll be raised up because now we have more of the surface root structure visible. Same process, start at the surface, see what kind of root flare it might have. See, further you go down, the bigger it gets. You know, one good thing about this type of material where it kind of grew wild, it doesn't have this coiling process that you often find when you buy nursery stock. So those of you that have any property, put a crape myrtle or Chinese elm or anything like that, put it in the ground and occasionally harvest it, and then the remaining root will keep coming back. So you have a more or less a permanent source of material. See how big that trunk is? Like I was saying, we have to do this to get the stability. I planted it deep so it's stable, but now I'm in the process of exposing as much of it as I can, because in bonsai, this is one of the highly valued areas. I believe this is the front, so let's just quickly trim. You don't have to do a lot of deep thinking, because this is just a raw material. I think this might be a better apex. This here, or this here, this one I think will be a better one. Yes. And then that means this should be shorter. Okay, so basically that goes back in the container. So basically, the first stage, when we dig it out, you're only looking for survival. So you do everything necessary to make it survive. And a lot of the time, it's about thinning out the top. And then in this case, we bury it deep for stability. And then second, third year, whenever it seems ready, we start to expose. So this too has a really nice trunk in there. Yeah. This is questionable. This was the root that got cut, but it's in our new shoot. So do I cut it? Or not? And probably should be cut, because it really doesn't add to the design at all. So I'm going to cut it across here. Okay, I just cut this off, right? Well, see the root hair here? I could plant this and it'll grow. It'll continue to grow. That's how prolific crape myrtles are, just like Chinese elm and a bunch of things like that. Once you have it in the garden and try to get rid of it, it's almost impossible, because they keep resprouting from the remaining root. So what we're gonna do is do like this and plant it. Hey, this is one of our freebies again. Okay, quick trim. This is probably an apex if it stays at all, and or we might even cut it down to here and make it into a shohin. That's about it. There's some growth down here. But now we're ready for this season. Okay, that looks like the front. And you can see that I put it in a container and raised it as high as it could go. If I went any higher, it'd be too hard to water. So I have to leave about an inch or so that water doesn't spill over. Okay, so this is the first one. Let's let it go around once. So you could see that it has a nice, good line. Apex probably needs to be worked a little bit more, but that'll come in the next, well, this year, and most likely by next year, this should look really good, probably ready for a bonsai container. So when you dig something from nature or more like your garden, make sure you're aggressive and get it down to its basic line. Too many people leave too many lines and get confusing as time goes on. So this is the first one of the three. The age of these, it's hard to remember. I would say anywhere from 7 to 10, maybe even older than that. But like I was saying, this is not a planting from seed or plant, but from a root cutting. Well, this is more of a natural root cutting. When I remove the plants that were in container, the root that had come out of the drain hole stayed in the ground, and these proceeded to grow again. So it's basically a root cutting, a little bit more natural than what we normally do around here. So I could see that this one here might be better if I cut it to here in the future. You know, these are the things you start to see when you're trying to videotape. But I think you can see what we have. This is the third. I think we're looking at the backside right now as it comes around. And then you see this over here? This is not the true apex. I want this to burst with all kinds of branches, and most likely it will start turning somewhere there. So these get done in stages. So as it comes around, I think the front is about right there. Okay, so I'll leave you again. This has been the three crepe myrtles that sort of grew voluntarily in the ground, and I dug it out last year. So it's been about one growth season. We're going into the next. When you watch this video, you should be about the right time. I'm shooting this and working on it in the first week of January. It's a little bit early for most. I recommend that you start a little bit later. So just about the time you see these videos is about the right time. So anyway, this is Hero saying goodbye. I'll see you again real soon in another chapter. So these were the three crepe myrtles dug out last year.